Hey guys, Nick Espinoza, your chief security fanatic here, and today I'm talking about Facebook because Facebook has decided to combat things like anger, depression, anxiety, and addiction in a very interesting way. Now, before I dive into what they're actually doing, let's talk about Facebook for a moment. We have now had a lot of longitudinal studies from about 2010 or so when we were looking at interactions, especially with the youth, in Facebook as they interact with this. And as a result of this, we have seen basically, essentially what is a correlation between anger, depression, suicidal thoughts, self-harm and all of that in the younger generations from about age 13, around 2011 or so, and continuously tick up. For boys, it goes up quite a bit. For girls, it went up dramatically. And so now, as we are looking at this and we have actual studies, evidence, and data to review, we're starting to see some of the downfalls of what being addicted to a Facebook can do for you, not to mention how you're using it, which can also cause addiction, anger, depression, etc., everything that I've just mentioned. And a lot of that revolves around the like button. Believe it or not, that is something that people get either a dopamine hit, anger, anxiety, or depression over. If you are, let's say, looking at your peers and saying, oh, my friend is getting more likes than me, especially for somebody that's younger, that may be actually very alarming or disarming to them in some way, shape, or form. That's a very serious issue that we have. And so Facebook has decided to roll out a test in Australia. They're the only ones that have this right now, where basically your friends can still like, interact, all this kind of stuff, and you can see how many posts or how many likes or interactions you get with your posts, but you can't see interactions of anybody else. And this applies to everybody in Australia. So in other words, that competition that you had with your friend who gets, you know, 1,000 likes and you get 10, you know, that goes away in that sense. Now, obviously there might be other ways to look at this in terms of the level of commenting and all of that, but Facebook is now proactively doing something like this as a test to see what this will do in terms of population. Now, we've seen Facebook rolled out psychological tests and studies before and not tell the general population on this. In one case, they affected 500,000 people by turning half of their feeds into very negative things. In other words, negative news, everything having a lot more of a negative connotation as it's in your newsfeed versus positive. And they didn't tell anybody about it because this is what Facebook does. They're a horrible company. This, though, they're being transparent about and they're actually telling us what they're doing here. And so it's going to be very interesting to see where this goes and what this does, but it's looking like this could be one of those things that actually helps in the sense that while we still have addictions to our mobile devices, phones, and all of this, this is one less mechanism, one less trigger, for anger, depression, all this kind of stuff, especially when you are growing up and learning how to develop your own social networks, non-technological social networks, and everything else. So I think this is a good move. We'll see where this goes. Facebook has also been pioneering this on Instagram, but obviously Facebook is the much bigger platform. So we'll see where this goes, and hopefully we're going to get some very positive results from Australia that we can roll out worldwide and start combating all of this negativity that we have seen, stemming from these social media platforms that we now have data for because they've been around for about a decade-ish, and now we can do something. So take that for what it's worth, but that is your news of the day. And please like, share, follow me here on Facebook and Twitter at Nick AESP. And please feel free to subscribe to me on YouTube as well. I promise I'll see all of your likes. And as always, stay safe and stay online. Thanks, guys.